When you die, that is not the end. Your greatest concern about your loved one, about yourself, should not be celebration of funeral. Where is their soul? For it is appointed unto man once to die, and after death, judgment. Your brother, your sister, your relative, have you thought of their souls? When was the last time you went on your knee praying? Your auntie, who sponsored you, gave her money to buy ticket for you to come to Canada. She is not born again. The only thing you are thinking of is to buy a mobile phone for her. When was the last time you fasted? Oh Lord, at least for the good she has done for me. Lord, have mercy. Save her soul. We are interested in funeral. We celebrate in Ghana. Come here and celebrate. When it is time for funeral, that is where we show our crutchy powers. And we do it for people to say, wow. That's what we do. But we don't know that the moment a person dies, close their eyes like this, the soul has left and the soul will face God. Immediately your soul is left and is going like that, and it gets to a place, they say stop, and they stop, they say let us bring the book. It is called the book of life. They will look into the book, and when your name is not in that book, that is the end of you. You are damned. We are not thinking of that. We are thinking of going to do a cemetery, cover it, do blocks, do shine coffin, import coffin from Germany. It changes nothing. Give that person 4 days in the coffin, the body will decompose. It changes nothing. Put the person in a wawa board, put the person in a dakato, whatever you will do, death is death. And the body is left here. It's the soul, the soul, the soul, the soul, the soul will face the consequences. Life is not ending here. And we are so interested. We are so interested. Gone were the days we used to cry in a funeral. We used to mourn. These days it has become fashion. Even our funeral cloth has become designer wear. You see young ladies showing their breasts on the funeral cloth. It has become a place for prostitution, a place for promiscuity, a place for impression. And we are focusing on that. And most of us in the church, that's the same thing we are doing. At the funeral, we organize, call unbelievers, come and play useless worldly songs. And we are dancing to the tune. We have forgotten that for unto man, there is an appointment. Hey, where you gain everything, and all is said and done, where will your soul be? Are you crying for the souls, or you are just there jubilating and organizing fried rice? And sharing wine, and you have gone. They say, oh, Nibano Eboganaba. And you are sharing alcoholic drinks, and you are sharing, distributing it, feeling that my Jemmy man, ye man, I feel. But Bible say asrabo fo ebe fa no ko soro ehin na okra no be hwi. Do we think about that? Is a pastor saying when your mother died, when your father died, don't honor them? Honor them. But your greatest concern should not be funeral. Your greatest concern should be their soul. Whilst they are alive today, whilst your brother is alive today, what is it you are doing? You are thinking that when they die, I will show everybody that I've landed. It's useless. It's useless. If they could come back to life, they would tell you, stop what you are doing. You should have told us about Jesus. You should have introduced Christ to us. You should have brought salvation. You should have established a church in our village. You should have let the pastor come to our lives. Funerals. Funerals. And we are trying to even reduce the church to a funeral club. So that the church will just be funeral, funeral, funeral. Hey. A year, 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 a That is the only one I hear in Munyamu. Yeah, can you not pack or trot the end? Go far flower free Italy. Maybe you natural training in RIP and cash. RIP may be a rest in punishment.